Hey guys, Magenta Squash here. I just got done with my pasta dinner, and for dessert, I decided to reheat some cookies. So I wanted to show you guys three different ways to reheat your cookies and rate each one of them for which one is the best. So let's get the cookies. Here are the three cookies that we will be working with today. First of all, we have a birthday cookie. It is 16 days old. Happy birthday. Second of all, we have a double chocolate chunk cookie. Third of all, we have a quarter of a double chocolate chunk cookie. This one is also 16 days old. Let's go. The three methods that we will be using for reheating the cookies are a toaster, a pot, and a microwave.
Maybe you should show them the inside.
Oh yeah, okay. The first method that we will be trying is the toaster. For the toaster, I will be using the birthday cake cookie. Happy birthday, let's go. So, after using the toaster method, it appears that our cookie is still cold. The toaster usually works well, so I'm shocked. Due to this, I'm going to give the toaster method 0 out of 10. For our next method, I will be using the pot. For this, I will be using a double chocolate chunk cookie. Let's go. We have to turn up the pot. And then we wait. If I've learned anything from SpongeBob SquarePants, it's to always flip your Krabby Patties. This isn't a Krabby Patty, but it's close. So I'm gonna flip it. And then we wait more. Do you think that it is ready?
Yeah.
We will now be turning off the pot. The cookie is slightly reheated, but it's still cold in the middle. I will give this method a 4 out of 10. So for the final method, we are going to be using the microwave. And for this method, I'm going to be using the quarter of the double chocolate chunk cookie. So looking at the microwave, there are 6 different options for foods that the microwave can reheat. If you know anything about cookies, you would know that a cookie does not fall into any of these categories. However, using some inductive scientific reasoning, you can see that the cookie looks very similar to the baked potato. Hence, this is the option that I will be using for the reheating process. Let's go. It's getting smoky, so we're gonna deviate from our protocols and stop the microwave early. Do I take it out? Oh, I'm spooked. Oh no! Is it in there still?
Yep, it's in there.
Here is the cookie, fresh out of the microwave. As you can see, it seems a little bit burnt, but I'll still give it the taste test.
Be careful.
Is it gonna be hot? I guess we'll see. Alright, so the cookie tastes a little bit burnt, but the microwave sure did heat the cookie to the core. I will give this method a 10 out of 10. Good job, microwave. The first method we used was the toaster, which we used to heat up the birthday cake cookie. Happy birthday. The result of that was a cookie that was not hot to the core and not warm to the touch. As for the pot, the result of that was a cookie that was not hot to the core, but warm to the touch. And for the microwave, we got a cookie that was hot to the core and warm to the touch. We have yet to find a cookie that is hot to the core, but not warm to the touch. We will be continuing research in that field. So if you're interested, you can subscribe to see what we come up with. Here's a graph of the methods and the score. So as you can see, as we go from toaster to microwave, the score increases in a linear fashion. Thanks to our loyal sponsors.